Let's do a quick dive into this question. Can a piece of wire act as a radio coil? It's a kind of rhetoric question because the answer is of course. Every piece of wire, here we see wire wound into a coil, but every piece of wire can act as a kind of a radio coil. So let's take this example. We have a piece of wire from 1 centimeter. Or we have a piece of wire of 10 centimeter. Or 30 meters. The physical phenomenon is that the wavelength is directly related to the length of the wire. So when this piece of wire is entered by an oscillator that oscillates on 1 centimeter waves, this piece of wire can get into oscillation. Exactly the same here. When a radio transmitter transmits at a piece of wire of 10 centimeters and the frequencies are the same, this piece of wire will also start to oscillate. And you can measure that with a scope or whatever. And here 30 meters, exactly the same. But of course such a piece of wire doesn't exist as a kind of a floating piece of wire in the air. So this piece of wire, of course, has certain capacitance by itself and a certain capacitance to ground. Say we take a piece of wire from 1 centimeter, put it here on the table. There is capacitance going from this side to that side and also to earth, ground. And here we have exactly the same. And also here, 30 meters, you can consider, for instance, this as an antenna spanned out in the open air. This antenna will have a capacitance from the bottom to the top and also a capacitance opposite to ground, the earth. So it's that will all have effect on the frequency, on the resonance frequency. Anyway, here is that test oscillator, and I will publish the link to the test oscillator. And here I have a piece of wire. And that piece of wire oscillates now on a certain frequency. I don't know the exact frequency, but anyway, it oscillates. And I have to tell that this oscillator doesn't go higher than 12 megahertz. That's of course a kind of flaw in the video, but anyway, I'm gonna pull this piece of wire out. And we're going to look at the scope, what happens. So I've pulled the piece of wire out now, here, and there is no oscillation visible. Perhaps when I had a better oscillator that worked on higher frequencies, this piece of wire could be got into oscillation. I push it again back now, and now it's back in its original form, and we see an oscillation. But anyway, every piece of wire can be brought into oscillation in a certain situation. So that's visible here. The piece of wire and here the coil. When you wind wire into a coil, you have capacitance here between all these windings. There's capacitance and there is inductance, of course. So here in this coil there is an unseen capacitance, and that is responsible for the frequency that this coil gives. So say perhaps it's 50 picofarad or so. That's only an idea, but anyway. And important to tell, here is the relation between the length of a wire in meters, the frequency, and the velocity of the radio waves in a medium. In some formulas, that medium is told to be in a vacuum, but in the air, radio waves move not in the same way compared to a vacuum. So there is a kind of damping, and that has to be taken in account. Anyway, we are talking about the wave theory and also other things on Earth, like trees, etc., etc., can have an effect on the propagation of radio waves. So, of course, a piece of wire can act as a coil. It has a specific frequency, and especially when we have two wires close to each other, there is a capacitance here, there is a capacitance here, and there is an inductance here on that wire. And consider, for instance, two wires over a length of 10 kilometers with a certain distance. There will surely be a very substantial effect from the capacitance between this wire and this wire, and this wire can also be the shielding. And of course, when you have a coax cable, this is the shielding, this is the central wire, and there is surely a big capacitance between these two wires that has an effect on the frequency, on the possibilities to make radio waves travel through that coax cable, etc. So that was more or less all to tell. I wish you luck.